right? So I am going to build StarCourt Mall. I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go into my closet, I'm going to grab a few base plates, and hopefully everything turns out right. Day 3 or something like that, and I'm starting to use some pretty strange pieces I've never used before. That's how big this thing is. Alright, I'm a couple days in, and I'm starting to get a whole lot of progress done. It already weighs a little bit more than a regular modular, and it's not even halfway done, so I got a lot more work to do.
Hey, what's going on, guys? It is Jack here, and today I'm showing you a massive LEGO creation. This thing is StarCourt Mall from Stranger Things Season 3. I built this thing, and I'm showing you this video today in celebration of Season 3 coming out yesterday, but I can't exactly say everything in this video is going to be completely accurate because at the time of this recording, I haven't seen Stranger Things Season 3 yet because it's not out. So, bear with me. But nonetheless, this thing is still an epic mock. In fact, it's my biggest mock yet. It's built on a 48 by 80 base plate. That thing is absolutely massive. Before I dive completely into this mock, I'm gonna give you a little bit of an overview so it makes a little bit more sense. So a little bit ago, I actually took a trip to see some of the Stranger Things filming locations. I'll leave a link to that vlog down below if you wanna see that. But I went to Gwinnett Place Mall, which is actually the mall where they filmed Stranger Things Season 3, and that is actually what StarCourt Mall is. That's the building they used. And when I walked in, you were on the second story. So ground level was even with the second floor, and the first floor was underground. Because of that, I raised up the ground level on this building to about 8 studs high or something like that, and the reason I did that was to make it so that it was accurate to the actual building. You walk in on the first floor and you're really on the second floor. Trickery. Not only did that save tan parts, but it gave it a lot more depth and made it a whole lot more interesting than other buildings I've done in the past. But continuing with the basic overview, you have the sidewalk out front, the facade entrance, and when you walk in, you're on the second floor with stores on either side, and escalators lead you down to the courtyard with stores on either side again. So with that out of the way, let's go ahead and dive straight into the beef of this video. The first thing I want to talk about is just how annoying it was to build this front facade. As you can see, there are a lot of triangles out front, and that wasn't just a decision I made like, hey, let me try and build something that looks cool. I had to make this look like StarCourt Mall or Gwinnett Place Mall, so I had to try and figure out how to make 3 triangles in one condensed area, and boy, was that not fun. No joke, it took me about 2.5 hours just to design the front entrance. That's it. It's not even huge at all. It's like 16 studs by 16 studs, and it took me that long. It was crazy, but I think it looks really good and very accurate. If you look at this little bit of reference material, you can see that StarCourt Mall has a little triangular section that juts out in front of everything else, and on top of that is a glass pyramid, and behind that is yet another triangular section. To build that, all I did was add some turntables to the front of the building and attach a corner piece to it, and I think it looks pretty good. It makes a triangular appearance when put to its side, and it's also pretty flush up against the actual facade. The glass pyramid was the most tricky portion, and this thing took me the longest to design out of this whole little section. Unfortunately, I don't have a lot of trans clear pieces, so I used some window frames here and had to fake depth. If you don't know what that means, basically I made the front of the pyramid a whole lot larger than the backside. That's just to make the pyramid look a lot bigger from far away, otherwise it would look really weird. Trust me, I tried it and it looked very ugly. And behind that, all I did was try and fake the depth in the final triangle. Basically, I just built multiple triangles, each getting smaller, and pressed them all together. This way I can kind of fake that indentation look you see on the actual build. And to really complete this entryway, I included all the glass doors, stores and also made sure to put a bunch of neon lights. StarCourt Mall is an 80s mall, so it had a lot of neon light strips going everywhere, so I tried to emulate that the best I could, but obviously it doesn't look perfect. And next to that front entryway is the brown section of the walls, which actually is very ugly in my opinion. I don't like the way it looks on the actual building itself, but again, this thing isn't meant to look super duper pretty, so to emulate that, all I did was add some brown texture bricks and I inset them by half a brick, and then I just littered the sidewalk with the appropriate details to match the actual StarCourt Mall. There's a bike rack in front of the left brown wall, and on the right side, well, there was nothing here in the actual thing, so instead I just included a trash can and a newspaper stand. And the last thing on the facade is just some windows on the far left and right hand sides. These things don't add any value to the actual building, but they are pretty accurate, and in front of those windows are just some simple hedge designs. These things are pretty simple, but I like the way they look. It's pretty accurate to those weird bushes that are trimmed to look like giant blocks of green rectangles. Now, as I was mentioning before, this thing is raised up a lot to compensate for the first floor being underground. So to make that look a whole lot prettier than just putting bricks, I decided to do a little bit of terrain work. When I first started building this thing, it looked absolutely disgusting. Like, no lie, I thought this thing was gonna turn out to be absolutely horrific. I did not like the way it looked at all, but I kept with it and I think it looks really cool. To kind of hide the weird colors, I decided to make it a little bit of an Easter egg. Underneath the sidewalk, it transitions from earthy tones all the way to the upside down. I don't think the upside down of StarCourt Mall is going to be in season 3, but I decided to include it just as a little memoir to the previous seasons. And to really top this thing off and really sell the Stranger Things vibe, I decided to include the plaque that comes in the Stranger Things set. You know, I just got the set, so I thought it'd be a pretty cool addition to this mock. But that's pretty much it for the outside, except for the roof. This thing is not complete. It doesn't extend all the way back. All I did was include some AC units enough to sell the effect of this being the actual mall. It doesn't extend all the way back because there is no back. The back is completely open. I wanted to make it feel like you could actually extend this mall and keep on going and make it so big that it's huge. I don't know. But without further ado, let's stop stalling and check out the inside. To give an overview of the inside layout, on the far right is a Radio Shack inspired building, on the far left is the music store, the hairstyling place, and downstairs is a shoe place, a generic fast food restaurant, a toy store, and a clothing store. From a distance, this really looks like a mess, and it kind of is, but I just want to stress that malls are very colorful, very poppy, and nothing really matches because every store tends to have its own vibe. But when you first enter, everything kind of matches. You go through the front doors and you're on a balcony, you can see the floor below you, and you can also take the escalators downstairs. Right next to the entrance is just a set of benches on either side. I decided to use the brown wall space to turn it into a lounge area. I wasn't sure what to use here, but I did not have a lot of lounging space in my last mall, which will be linked down below. But on the far left hand side, the first store I want to cover is the music store. Now, the big thing about the 80s that I remember, actually I was never alive, but the big thing about the 80s that I really think about when I think of the word the 1980s, I mean, I can't speak. Let's just say my favorite thing about this decade is the music. I think that's everybody's favorite. There's just a lot of cool songs and good songs that came out of this decade. So to capture that, I decided to build a music store. This thing captures everything about the decade, from vinyl record players all the way to cassette tapes, to boom boxes, to everything. There's also a lot of instruments. Everything about the 80s music is just in here, at least all I could actually produce. And I'm pretty happy with the result. It's actually one of my favorite stores in this entire mall just because it represents something, and it's not just something where I threw it in because I had space, like a couple other things like the store next to it, which we'll move on to after I talk about the minifigures, because we were just talking about the 80s and building stuff that's iconic from it, so there are a couple minifigures in here that really scream 80s. If you've ever seen the movie Hairspray, you'll know that in the 80s there was a lot of frizzy hair, and I mean a lot of it. I wasn't there to see it, but I can't imagine what it would have been like to have hair that jumps up 6 inches above your scalp. So I took a lot of inspiration from that when designing some figs. As you can see with this figure, there's a lot of frizzy hair here. This woman has a lime green jumpsuit with no sleeves and no shoulder pads, weirdly enough. But this girl really screams 80s to me, and I was really proud of it when I made it. I know it's just a minifigure, but I was pretty happy with it. Another figure I included as an Easter egg is Doc Brown from Back to the Future. Stranger Things 3 takes place in 1985, and so does that movie, or that's when that movie came out. So I decided to include him as just a little memoir to another great franchise. I love how this video is flowing, because directly next to that store is the hairstylist place. This is a place where all the 80s hair can actually come to life. Al from the detective's office actually has a job here, so you can actually get him to do your hair. It's 1950 style, but it will work. All that's in here is just a working desk, a chair for you to actually get your hair styled, and a wig to show off the hair to the outside places of the mall. On the opposite side of StarCourt, there is a Radio Shack inspired building. In season 3 and season 2 and season 1 of Stranger Things, there is a Radio Shack, so I decided to include something that's kind kind of inspired, but instead of just being all audio equipment and everything, I decided to include a lot of technology here from the 80s. As you can see with the old computers, these things are like blocks or bricks. They're really hefty and they probably don't do much, but I decided to make sure you could tell this thing was from the 80s. On the shelf next to that is some more audio equipment. I know we just had a music store, but you can't have a Radio Shack inspired building without having some radios and some boomboxes and some speakers, so I decided to include that to really sell the effect. And on the opposite end of the store is a small area. This is basically just the checkout counter and the customer service desk. All I wanted here was just some video cameras and some boxes holding phones and everything like that, which is actually what the red boxes on the other side of the store are. But that will cover it for the first floor, so let's go ahead and dive into the second floor, which is actually the first floor, and man, I'm horrible at voiceovers. When you head down the snot escalators, you're taken to a courtyard with a fountain directly inspired by the Season 3 StarCourt Mall ad. And that's built using a couple different techniques. I do like the way the water looks. It's very shiny and reflective. It's also very lazy, but there's no other way for me to make it look good with the curved macaroni pieces. Directly behind that is a set of benches beneath the escalators. Those things are pretty simple, but again, it gives some extra recreational purposes because in the StarCourt Mall ad, it says you can hang out here. Behind those benches is the first store on this bottom floor, and this is a shoe store. The sign has a couple 1x1 plates which show you the shoes that you can buy. It's funny because they fit on minifigures' feet, get it? Haha. But inside are just a couple display tables showing the shoes that you can buy. They're not flashy, they're literally just 1x1 plates. There's no other way to actually make good looking shoes. But other than just a couple shelves in the back, there's really nothing else I could have crammed inside such a small space. This is one of the smallest stores except for the toy store, which is directly next to it, but I'd rather show that later. So let's just go right where we can see a generic fast food restaurant cloaked in lime green. When you walk in, there's a small kiosk so you can actually order food and, you know, get reservations, because you definitely get reservations in fast food restaurants. But there's also a fountain drink machine directly next to that and some stairs that will lead you down to the seating area. Everything here is built using very simple building techniques, but I do like the way the fountain drink machine turned out. That's one of my favorite parts of this fast food restaurant, but I did also decide to include a kitchen here so it actually makes sense where you get the food, because I don't tend to do that a lot, and it really doesn't make sense because the food just kind of spontaneously appears. On the opposite side of the wall is a reflection of the fast food restaurant in terms of shape and size, except there's a slice where it divides into two stores, but this is a clothes store. This store is kind of plain, but it does let you hook up with all the latest fashion trends, including shoulder pads, jumpsuits, life jackets, punk rock vests, all those things. And directly next to that is the final store in this entire building, and this is just a reference to the fact that there are no video games in the 1980s. I can't stress this enough, but this is a 1980s mall. This is just a little place where you can go get some toys, play with things, and know that it's not a Jurassic Park Raptor. The movie was not out yet, and I know there's a book. Forgive me. But that will cover all of this mock. I know I had a lot to cover in such a short amount of time, but I took a long time, so never mind. Scratch that, but I hope you guys enjoyed. One thing I do want to mention, because I completely forgot to actually say it, but hopefully you could tell by the actual intro to this video, this is a collaboration with Avaki and TD Bricks. We all made our own StarCourt malls, and boy, were they amazing. Avaki's was the one that was made first and inspired me and Ty, so make sure to go check those out. If you want to see more Stranger Things mocks, I will leave them linked down below. But as always, thanks so much for watching, and most importantly, take care, guys.